Welcome back to Horsemaster with Julie Goodnight.
I'd like this horse to learn to carry his head where I want it to be, not where he wants it to be. And for Western Pleasure, what we want is a fairly low headset. So we want roughly the tip of the ears to be even with the withers. And so first thing is I have to get clear on where I want the horse's head to be. And then secondly, it's just an easy matter to apply pressure when the head is not where it's supposed to be and release the pressure when it's where I want. So anytime he picks his head up, I'm going to raise my hands and apply alternating rein pressure until the head drops down. As soon as it drops down, I'm going to release the pressure to reward him. Anytime it comes up, I'm going to lift my hands, apply pressure to his mouth, alternating rhythm, 1, 2. And as soon as he drops the pull down, I'm going to release the pressure so he's comfortable when his head is in the place I want it to be. I'd also like him to frame up just a little bit, meaning that I want him to round his neck and I'd like his face to come closer to the vertical. So in order for Diane to reach her goals, to be able to show this horse, not only are we going to have to get his head set lower and frame him up a little bit, but we want his gaits to be slower and more consistent. So I'm going to sit back at the trot and I'm going to rock my hips from side to side so that I can maintain his rhythm with my seat. I want him to seek out my rhythm rather than the other way around. So I'll keep this side-to-side rhythm in my hips very slow and steady. And he'll feel my rhythm and he'll know that he needs to come to my speed rather than the other way around. I don't like his habit of just stopping whenever he wants. A horse's job is to go where I point him and at the speed I dictate. And he should maintain that direction and speed until I tell him to do something different. So I'd like to see Diane be a little bit more assertive with him and actually get after him a little bit when he stops on her. So I'm finding it doesn't really take much to correct his head position. And I think that what Diane really needs to do is get a little clearer in her mind exactly what she wants of this horse and then insist that he do it. Really, I think he'll be happy to do it. He's not a bad little horse. I think with his head down and his neck rounded, he's going to look a little better, a little flashier. He's a pretty little horse. And I want to think him into a slow gait. So I'm going to really concentrate on the side-to-side rhythm that I feel in my hips. And I want to keep that rhythm very slow and steady so he learns to ride at my pace rather than the other way around. With a little bit of consistency, I think this horse is going to train up really nice and do well in the show ring. He's got a lot going for him. He just needs a little bit more dictation on what it is he's supposed to do. Well, Diane, how did that look?
That looks real good.
Okay, well, you think you're ready to give it a try?
I'm ready.
Well, let's switch places.
Okay.
And remember, I just want you to think consistency. I want you to be telling this horse when to go, what speed to go, and where to put his head.
Okay.
All right, Diane, go ahead and take him out on a nice circle around me. And I want you to keep your legs on this horse all the time. Good. Get after him a little bit when he balks on you. Let's go ahead and start him at a walk. Good. Now, as you walk along, I want you to feel his back moving from right to left, right to left. That's it. and feel your right leg, then left leg, close on his sides. That's what you're going to use to keep him moving forward. Right leg, left leg, right leg, left leg. Do you feel that?
Mm-hmm.
Good. All right. Now, the key is you're going to use your hands in timing with your legs. So when your right leg closes on the horse, I want you to squeeze the right rein. When your left leg closes on the horse, squeeze the left rein. So instead of pulling on two reins, oh, good. I want right, left, right, left. When he breaks at the pole and drops his head, I want you to just drop your hands down towards his neck. Anytime he picks his head up, go right back to the right, left, right, left, in timing with your legs. Nice, Diane. Nice. Loosen the rein up when his head comes down. Good. Very nice. Now, he's learned already that when he feels that right, left pressure, that means you want him to drop his head. So when he gets his head to the place you want it, which is about right there, stop the right, left pressure, drop your knuckles down towards his neck. Excellent. So anytime his head comes up, you're going to pick your hands up, right, left, in timing with your legs. And anytime he drops his head down where you want it, release the pressure, drop your hands down to his neck. Now he'll start putting his head down. That's excellent, Diane. That's excellent. Okay. Didn't take much to teach that to him. What I'd like you to do now is practice this. Just practice that one thing, getting his head down to the level that you want it. You can practice it at all three gates. Whenever his head comes up, pick your hands up, right, left, and timing with your legs. As soon as he drops, drop your knuckles down to his neck. Let him have a little bit of slack.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Makes sense.
Okay. I'd like you to practice over the next day, and I'll come back tomorrow and check in on you and see how you're both doing.
Okay. Good
deal.
All right.
Very good.
Thank you.
Stay tuned to Horsemaster with Julie Goodnight.